I've dismantled the safety valve, and here you can see the components laying on the workshop table. The valve was earlier removed from the main engine exhaust gas economizer. First step is to always carry out a visual inspection for the condition and to determine any clear signs of damage or leak. This is followed by a thorough cleaning of all the internal parts. The mating surfaces between the valve bonnet and the valve body already has a gasket in between, but this surface needs to be checked as well. The seat is one of the most critical areas, and special care must be taken not to damage the surfaces while carrying out cleaning. You can use the surface of your fingernail or the tip of the finger to feel the surface to determine the presence of any surface defects or fine cracks. The spindle or stem along with the disc should be able to go in freely, and also there should not be any relative play between them. This isn't the best lighting, but here you can see how they combine. The ship is around 10 years old, and despite a thorough surface cleaning, the parts will never look like new. The boiler water treatment, operating parameters, and chemicals involved, thus leading to a chemical reaction with the valve material, are also a contributory cause. Discoloration is not a big deal, but pay special attention that there are no pitting or corrosion marks on the mating surfaces. Since the spring is in compression all the time, it has a natural tendency to lose the spring effect. Carrying out a visual inspection for cracks followed by a ring test should be enough. You should hear a loud, shrill ring sound, which means all is in order. A dull dud sound means that the spring is cracked and needs to be replaced. Other than that, check the height of the spring and compare that with a new one. Then reuse or replace the existing spring based on the findings and after cross-referencing it with the information in the instruction manual. The two spring carriers also need to be checked for the obvious corrosion, pitting, and grooving marks. The valve body is flanged for piping or mounting connections. Despite the gasket which will be installed, these surfaces need to be checked for their condition, particularly for any high-pressure steam cut, which can sometimes be the case if there was a steam leak. The four pieces of diesel generators on our ship, each rated 4 MW, also have a connected economizer to their exhaust. I'll explain about the safety valve from those in the next videos. Subscribe to be notified when that video is up, and hit like if you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.